Hello everyone. So I hope that you have completed the table 3.1 that I have already told to complete in session 1. So before we will start our second point, that is types of synthetic fibers, first we will revise about synthetic fibers. So already we have learned in session 1, but again we will just take a look on synthetic fibers. So the first point is, synthetic fibers are made of small units of chemicals joined together in the form of large chain. The form chain is called polymer. Okay, so the small unit that actually is known as a monomer. Mono means single. Okay, so the single units of chemicals we are joining together and forming a large chain, which is known as polymer. Next, we have learned that the polymer is a Greek word in which poly means many and mer means units. Okay, so polymer is a Greek word which means the poly plus mer. So poly means many, okay, many units we are using, and mer means the repeating units. See, the poly means many and mer means units. So many units is known as polymer. Next one, we have learned about the cellulose, okay, the natural fiber, that polymers occur in nature also. Example, cotton is a polymer called cellulose, and cellulose is made up of a large number of glucose units. So one glucose means monomer, and when many glucose we are just joining and forming a large chain is known as polymer. Okay, so cotton is also a polymer, which is a natural fiber. So like this we have completed our revision. Next point is types of synthetic fibers. So already we have learned in session 1 that nylon, rayon, okay, these are some examples, and like that we are going to learn one by one. So first type of synthetic fiber is known as rayon. Rayon is actually is known as artificial silk. Okay, now you are in 8th standard, so you know that the silk, which is a very expensive fiber. So instead of that, we can use this type of fibers, which is known as rayon. Silk fiber obtained from the silkworm, which was discovered in China. Okay, so China is the first country who discovered the silk fibers, and they kept as a closely guarded secret for a long time. Okay, after discovery of silk from silkworm, China just kept this secret because China don't want to share its knowledge to other countries. So that's why China done like this. So instead of silk, we can use the silk, which is known as artificial silk, which is known as rayon. Okay, so this is just history about the rayon, that is also cellulose fibers. The rayon is actually cellulose fibers. Now the cellulose word is there, means what? Using natural material we are making our artificial silk or rayon. Okay, so one by one we will complete the point. See, the fiber is obtained by chemical treatment of wood pulp, and this fiber is called rayon or artificial silk. So rayon is made from natural sources such as wood and some agricultural products, but normally for rayon we are using wood pulp, okay, which is a natural material. This is the first point. Next one, rayon fiber can be made in different colors by dyed, and rayon is very cheap as compared to silk. So as I told, the silk is very expensive, So, like that silk, if you want to use the fiber, you can use rayon, which available in different colors. Okay, artificial silk or rayon available in different color. Okay, by dyeing process, we can convert the natural fiber color into different artificial colors. So, the rayon is mixed with cotton to make bed sheets or mixed with wool to make carpet. So, many things that I have shown, see the image, two images are there. So, carpet is there and threads are there. So, that actually we are mixing the cotton and rayon to each other and then forming these articles. Okay, so that is all about the rayon. Okay, you have to just write some points in your notebook about the rayon. Don't copy from this slide as it is. Okay, don't copy from this. Again, I will explain about the rayon. Okay, so rayon is a fiber which is made up from wood pulp. Okay, rayon other name is artificial silk. Third point, you can write that the rayon is made up of cellulose fibers. Okay, the rayon fibers having quality, having the properties similar to silk. Means silk having whatever properties same as rayon also having that properties, and that's why we are saying the rayon as a artificial silk. Artificial means what we are making, the humans are making that silk. That's why the two names are there, that is rayon and artificial silk. So as the rayon is obtained from the natural source, that is a wood pulp, and it is a man-made fiber, so it is cheaper than silk. And it can be dyed in a wide variety of colors. Means we can use different colors of rayon fibers to make different things. So, normally 80 to 980 filaments, means the threads, we are using to make yarn. As we know that now, you are, means 8th standard students, you should know that the chain of the cloth. Means, first we are just taking fibers from nature, then we are converted into yarn. Okay, the threads we are arranging, and then the yarn we are used to make fabric, and that fabric we are going to use for our clothes. Correct? Fibers, yarn, fabric and clothes. Correct? So like that, the yarn is there, that yarn having 80 to 980 threads of rayon to make one yarn. And the rayon is actually optional for cotton and silk. Instead of cotton and silk, we can use rayon. Now why we are just using the rayons? Because that rayon having particular properties. So first property is that rayons are easily dyed in a wide range of colors. Okay, means directly we can take that rayon, add the color. Okay, next property is that the rayon fibers are very bright, means the color of the rayon is very bright. Next property is that rayon are very soft, smooth and comfortable, means after wearing the rayon clothes we feel very comfortable. Next one property is that the rayon fibers are very highly absorbent. Absorber means what? They can absorb moisture. So that's why I said that rayon clothes are very comfortable. So these are some properties, and because of these properties we can use rayon instead of silk. So I hope that you have learned about the rayon. Okay, rayon is a fiber which made up of wood pulp. Rayon is also known as artificial silk. Rayon is very cheaper than silk. Instead of silk, we can use rayon, as rayon having similar properties like silk. Then last point, that rayon is mixed with cotton to make bed sheets and mixed with wool to make carpets. So this is all about the rayon. Next synthetic fiber is nylon. So anybody know a story about a nylon? One myth is there. Myth means just imaginary story is there. That nylon, N-Y-L-O-N. So N-Y letters come from New York. N-E-W-Y-O-R-K, New York. And L-O-N come from London. Means the chemist who discovered the nylon, they came from these two cities. Actually, this is not 100% correct information. Actually, nylon word is come from many changes. Okay, so that New York plus London is actually a myth, imaginary story, but just keep in mind, you should know that about this story. So nylon is a second type of synthetic fiber, okay, which is also another man-made fiber in 1931. So in 1931, it was discovered, and this nylon is just made without using natural material. Means here we are not taking any plant material or any animal material. So instead of that, we are using petrochemicals like coal. So when nylon was discovered in 1931, actually it was prepared from coal, water and air, which was a fully synthetic fiber, not same as rayon. In rayon, rayon is a man-made fiber, that's why we are saying that rayon is a synthetic fiber, but not the fully synthetic, because in rayon production we are using natural things, so that is not a fully synthetic fiber. But the nylon was a first synthetic fiber, as it was prepared from coal, water and air. Understood about the history of nylon? Okay, so some another properties of nylon is there like rayon. So first property is that nylon is a wrinkle resistant. Now wrinkle means what? As we know that when we are wearing the cotton cloth and when we are sitting in chair for a long time, just check your cloth. Okay, some wrinkles are there. But if you are wearing nylon and if you are sitting for a long time, there are no wrinkles. So the first property of nylon is wrinkle resistance. Okay, next one is that nylon is very strong, elastic and light in nature. Strong means what? See this picture. The nylon is used for making socks, curtains. Okay, then see the parachute, ropes and some threads. Now imagine the parachute is just carrying a weight of these people, that the boy. Means that much the nylon is very strong, elastic in nature. Okay, this is a very lightweight fabric. Means if we are wearing the nylon, that is very lightweight. Means we are just feel that very light. Okay, so it is very lustrous, means the shine is there. You can see this thread, and from that you can just observe that the nylon fibers are very shiny and easy to wash. The nylon things are very easy to wash. So like that the properties are there. So when just I was said that the nylon is another man-made fiber in 1931. So actually in 1931 the nylon was first used in a bristle toothbrush. Nylon discovered in 1931, but the nylon is used in 1938 for making bristle of toothbrush, that bristle. Okay, so like that many things are there that made from the nylon, like socks, ropes, tents, toothbrushes, car seat belts, sleeping bags, curtains, the things we are using for food packaging, the medical equipments are there, the covers of medical equipment, so that also made from nylon. Okay, so that is all about the nylon. One another thing is that nylon is known as flame resistance, means less flammable. It is very slower to ignite, it is very slower to catch in the fire. But if nylon once sunlight will start to melt and can stick to your skin. So that's why the teachers are saying, all other people are saying, that don't wear the nylon clothes while if you are working in kitchen, because nylon is actually very slow to ignite. Ignite means what? Nylon can slowly catch the fire. But if that catch the fires that started to melt and that can stick to our skin, which is very hazardous. Okay, so that's why I am saying, this is my suggestion, don't wear the nylon clothes. Say to your mother that don't wear the nylon clothes if she is working in kitchen for a long time. Okay, so that is all about the nylon. See, again I will explain. Nylon is a man-made fiber. It was first fully synthesized fiber. Okay, fully synthesized means made by humans without using natural things. See, the production of nylon was started without using any natural raw material, that is from plant or animal. Next one is that it is synthesized from coal, water and air, the first nylon, that is in 1931. Clothes from nylon are very strong, elastic, light, lustrous and easy to wash. So actually these are the properties of nylon, that nylon is very strong, elastic, lightweight, lustrous, that is shiny and very easy to wash. Next point is that firstly nylon was used in making bristle of toothbrush commercially. Bristle, you know that the front part. Yes, so there the first nylon was used. And after that, it was used for making fabric. Next point, nylon is used for making clothes, ropes, socks, curtains, sleeping bags, and parachute, etc. So these are the examples that where we are using this nylon. Next, the nylon fiber is stronger than a steel wire. Okay. As we learn about the properties, this is the one important property, is that the nylon fiber is very stronger than a steel wire. And that's why we are using that nylon for making many things. So, nylon, we have completed the nylon and rayon. Third type of synthetic fiber is polyester. And fourth one is acrylic. So before we will start the polyester and acrylic, just open textbook page number 34. So one activity is there. Actually, we have to do this activity in lab because you don't have that stand. But if you want to do that activity, you can do. Okay. So first I will explain that activity, what you have to do. You have to take stand, okay, with a clamp. Then you have to take a cotton thread
about 60 centimeter. Then tie thread to that clamp so that it hangs freely. Okay, see the figure 3.5. Next, what you have to do at the free end, just you have to suspend a pan, means we have to place some weight, and for that we need a pan. Okay, after tying the thread, you have to add the weight one by one till the thread breaks. Means from that activity, actually you have to find out how much total weight required to break the thread. Okay, and then you have to fill the observation table 3.2. That activity we will do when our school will reopen. But still, if you want to do this activity, you can do at home. See, you may use a hook or a nail on the wall. Okay, you can use that for hanging the fibers and polythene bag at the other end. Then place the weight. You may use marbles, some pebbles, but of similar size. That marbles and pebbles should be of similar size. So instead of that stand and just pan, you can use these things to just carry out this activity. So as you wish, you can do at home. This is not compulsory. Only we have to just check how much total weight required to break the thread. And from that, we can just conclude that which fiber is strong. So for that activity is there, and you have to do that activity with cotton fiber, wool, silk and nylon. Okay, so that is all about the activity. Next one is polyester and acrylic we are going to learn. So polyester is another a synthetic fiber. Okay, and if we are using the polyester for making fabric, so that fabric made from this polyester does not get wrinkled easily. Same as nylon, means the wrinkled resistant fiber is there, this polyester. That polyester are also made from the petrochemicals. Okay, so in polyester and acrylic, actually you have to learn the properties. Means in rayon, in nylon, you have to learn history, properties and example. Same you have to do here for polyester and acrylic. You have to find out the history, then the properties and some examples. So see one by one. Polyester is made up of the repeating units of a chemical called an ester. So as we learn in natural fiber, in cellulose, that glucose units we are arranging and forming a large chain, which is known as polymer. And here the word is polyester. So poly, that is many, and ester means that chemical. Okay, so one ester, second ester, third ester, like that we are arranging the ester and forming a long chain, that is known as polyester, which is a man-made and or synthetic fiber. So again, here are some properties of polyester, that the fabric made from this fiber does not get wrinkled easily. Means the first property of polyester is polysters are wrinkle resistant. Next one, remains crisp and easy to wash. Means as we are just ironing, doing the ironing, same quality or same thing that remains when we are using the polyester things, and these polysters are very easy to wash like a nylon. Okay, so some examples are there of polyester, that is shirts, pants, jackets, bed sheets, curtains, saris, mouse pad. So many things we are making from the polyester. Again, the polyester is used to make ropes, then fabrics for conveyor belt, cushioning, insulating material in pillow, etc. So many examples are there where we are using this polyester. Okay, so another polyester is there,
that the most important example, that is terricot. Okay, terricot. Now see this terri plus coat, that actually a polyester we get by mixing the fibers of terrylene plus cotton. So that terry from terrylene and cot from cotton, means we are mixing these two things and forming the terricot. Another some polyester names are there, like a polycot, polywool. Same here, see polycot, polywool, means again here we are using polyester plus cotton, here we are using polyester plus wool. So like that, other fabrics we can mix in polyester and form other synthetic fibers. Okay, next one, another example is there, that is PET, that is polyethylene terephthalate. Okay, polyethylene terephthalate, which is a very familiar form of polyester, which is used for making bottles, utensils, films, wires and many other useful products. Now whatever the bottles from that we are just drinking the water and all, that some plastic like utensils are there, some wires are there, that actually made up from polyester, and that polyester name is PET. Okay, polyethylene terephthalate. So that is all about the polyester, which is made up of petrochemical. Okay, see the things where we are using the polyester, the mouse pad, water bottles are there, see the utensils is there, some spoons, whisker is there, then the wires are there, that all are made from polyester. Okay, understood about the polyester? Yes. See that polyester properties, cotton properties, and when we are adding the polyester and cotton, we get polycotton. See its qualities. See, first we will see about the polyester. Polyester is a durable. Durable means what? We can use that thing which is made up of polyester for a long time. Next one, dries quickly. As polyester does not absorb the moisture, does not absorb the water, that polyester dries quickly. Next one, less wrinkle, that wrinkle resistant. Okay, less fading means that easy to that I said about the crisp nature. Like next, cotton, that very soft and strong, easy to dye. Okay, and breathable means in summer season we can use the clothes that made from cotton. So these qualities of polyester, these qualities of cotton, and when we are just mixing this polyester and cotton, we get polycotton, and see the qualities. Qualities of both polyester and cotton mixed. See, no shrinkage, affordable means not very expensive, keep shape and color, breathable, soft and less fading. So like that, we are just making like this polyester. Okay, polyester, one another thing that I forgot to say, that ester is there. Ester is actually a chemical which gives fruits their smell. You know na, the fruits having smell. So that smell is because of this ester, this chemical substance. Understood? The general information is there. Just keep in mind. Next one is acrylic, the fourth type of synthetic fiber. So the acrylic is a man-made or synthetic fiber which resembles wool. You know now about the wool that we get from sheep, which is a natural fiber. Yes, instead of wool we can use acrylic. Okay, so same properties acrylic have, means like wool, the acrylic also having the same properties, and that's why the acrylic is also known as artificial wool or synthetic wool. Like the rayon is known as artificial silk. Don't confused. Okay. Artificial silk means your rayon, and artificial wool means your acrylic. So instead of silk, instead of wool, we can use rayon and acrylic. Okay. So see, acrylic resembles wool and it is called as artificial wool or synthetic wool. Next one, acrylic is cheaper than natural wool and can be made in various colors by dyeing. So as we know that the natural wool, okay, the natural fibers are there that we get from sheep. Actually, that wool that we get from sheep, we can dye, but normally the first colors are there, that is brown, black, white. But in acrylic, by using dyeing process, we can take different colors of fibers. And these acrylic fibers are very cheaper than natural wood. Next point is that clothes are made from acrylic are relatively cheaper than clothes are made by wool. Next, acrylic is used in making sweaters, blanket and other many clothes, like we are using wool. Means just check that if we are wearing the sweater, you have to find out that the sweater is made up of pure wool or this acrylic. So see, the sweater, then scarves are there, our stoles are there, hand gloves are there, that we feel that made up of wool, but sometimes these things can also made by acrylic which resembles wool. Means acrylic and wool, okay, for if you want to do the observation of this acrylic and wool, take clothes that made from acrylic and wool and just observe that you just confused between that, because acrylic is same like a wool. And that's why acrylic is known as a artificial wool or synthetic wool. Okay. Some things are there like burning properties or smelling properties. So from that you can just observe that about the wool and acrylic. Means if you want to find out that the cloth is made up of acrylic or wool. Means if you are confused that your sweater is actually made up of acrylic or wool, just take one thread from your sweater. Okay, don't use your new sweater. Okay, so one thread from just your sweater and burn that using lighter and all. If the burning or if the smelling is like plastic smell is there, so just consider that sweater is made up of acrylic. And if not, means if the smell is not like a plastic, means your sweater is made up of wool. So from that activity you can understand that your sweater is actually made up of acrylic or wool. So all this about the synthetic fibers, just check that rayon, nylon, polyester and acrylic. See, the main point I have written. So like that you have to write your own notes. So today's homework is that you have to write a short note on rayon, nylon, polyester, acrylic. Okay, you can use this session, you can use your textbook, and then you have to write your short notes point wise. Okay, see, the rayon is also known as artificial silk. Then the made up of wood pulp. So all I have given, that is very important points. Okay, so don't forget these points. Then rayon absorbs moisture and very comfortable to wear. Next is nylon, that is the first synthetic fiber that entirely made from chemicals, that is from coal, petroleum oil, air and water. Then the last last four slides are actually of properties, that nylon is very strong, elastic, wrinkle resistant, absorbs very little water, and that's why it dries quickly and very easy to wash. Next one is a polyester that made from monomer, that is single unit, is known as ester. Then manufactured from petroleum. See the properties, that is very extremely strong, chemical resistant, wrinkle resistant, very durable, does not absorb water easily and quick to dry. Next one is about the acrylic, which is a lightweight, soft and warm like wool. Properties, that wrinkle resistant, does not shrink and cheaper than wool, and can be dyed easily in a variety of colors. So all these about the types of synthetic fibers. Still, if you have any doubt, you can directly ask me in comment box. Okay, so that is all about the synthetic fibers. Today's homework is that you have to write short note on rayon, nylon, polyester and acrylic. Don't think that I'm not going to check your notes and all. Okay, I will check. So whenever I am giving homework, just note down and complete your homework on time. That is helpful to you only. See the activity that I have mentioned, 3.1, and that table. Okay, see. So here our second point is finished, that we have learned about the types of synthetic fibers. So I hope that you have learned, you have understand all these things. Okay, just stay home, stay safe. Now you know that how the things are very going dangerously, so please stay at your home and stay safe. Thank you.